The end is near.
I actually talked about this a little while back, and now it's on the way. So many of you know that fast food restaurants have been using dynamic pricing for a while. What dynamic pricing is basically they change the price of their menu items based on the time of day. They've been doing this for quite some time on apps like DoorDash and Uber Eats, which I know you guys were like, well, you shouldn't use those in the first place. But they've also started doing it in their restaurants now, where based on the time of the day, they will switch the prices around. So for example, if they have like a rush hour, if people are rushing in to buy things, then they will raise the prices and they will basically just observe when people are coming in versus when people are not. If they have a lot of people in the drive-thru, they'll just jack the prices up. Versus if there's no one there, then the menu items will just be what they're normally supposed to be priced. So for example, if a McDouble at McDonald's is usually $4.75, but there's a lot of traffic, then they'll raise the price to up to maybe even $7. Guess what? Now the retailers are doing this, which I absolutely called. I said this was going to happen, and it's going to be pretty sick. It's going to be sad as hell. I don't know how America is allowing this, but I mean, it's evidently legal. What this ultimately means is that people who come in at different times during the day will pay different prices, you know, and for different products. So while it may vary a bit, for example, if it's like, let's say a PlayStation 5, you know, the company that manufactures the product could say, well, you know what, this is what the normal price is. So you're going to pay $600 for a PlayStation 5 one way or another. When it comes to everyday things such as food, clothing, things that we need to actually survive and live, the prices of these products can change based on the time of day or even just how many people are shopping. So, you know, or the number of products that are currently left in stock. So, for example, if there's fewer products left in stock and, you know, and there are a lot of consumers coming in, they strategically know that they're going to move those one way or another. So they will basically alter the prices to the maximum amount that they can sell it for to get the most from it. So basically, only those who can afford it will get it. Or even those who really can't afford it, you have no choice. You're going to have to pay more for this. And it allows them to reduce inventory while charging more for inventory. Let's just go ahead and jump right into the video. It's not going to be 1 hour, it's this, and the next hour, it's that. Of course not. In the morning, you know, in the morning, if you want bread, you know, fewer people might come in the morning. So if you want bread in the morning, it might be $2 for that loaf versus if you come in a couple of hours later in the afternoon, that same loaf of bread may be $5.35 because there's more people in the store at that moment. And just to be clear, this whole thing about Wendy's pushing back on the pricing, the CEO actually talked about it initially, saying that, you know, this was a way to make more money and blah, 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 and admitted that it was, I believe he even used the word dynamic pricing. Okay. So this is what they call it, dynamic pricing. They're so greedy, so greedy right now. We're watching greedflation unfold, and it's basically a race to see who can extract as much money from the consumer as possible. Like, I mean, I showed you guys something very recently where, you know, it's costing now a crazy amount of money just for like a 10 piece chicken nuggets with a medium fries, medium drink. That's $14. That's $14 now. Right? And If you want to upgrade that, like, you know, if you want a large, then that's going to cost you quite a bit more, because if you want it, then you're going to have to pay for it. You know, it's like this is the insane reality that we now live in. Like, we're being starved. Let me correct myself. I said 14, but I was actually wrong about that. It's actually more than 14. There's my screen. So for 10 piece chicken nuggets meal right now, you know, it's, you know, for a lot of, this is for a lot of us, it's $14.69, right? And that's for me, that's for medium. So it's almost 15. I was wrong. I misspoke. You know, it's almost $15 for a 10-piece chicken nuggets, 10-piece chicken nuggets, medium fries, medium drink. Do you guys remember when drinks, you could get any drink from McDonald's for a dollar? Any drink for a dollar. Now they're like $5 a pop. Like, this is insane. This is insane, guys. A four-piece chicken nuggets used to be a dollar. A dollar. Okay? $14.69 for medium fries, medium drink, 10-piece. If you want a large, that's something like, there's a fee on that. So that's like $1.30. So basically $16. If you want a large, something like that. All right, $16, $17, and we're not even talking. And then if you want this bad boy delivered to you, oh my goodness, good things cost good money. And you know what they do in the apps is you basically have to, if you don't choose priority, you know, there's going to be some stops along the way. So they'll tell you, oh, you'll get your food in 10 and 15 to 25 minutes. Oh, your order has been delayed. It's not going to be an hour. Or even if it doesn't get delayed, the person that gets your order, because these guys are scumbags that do DoorDash and all these other crap, they know how to screw you. So even if you pay for priority, what they'll do is they'll just pick up another order. So if they're using Uber Eats, they'll just pick up another order with DoorDash that's in the same direction and go and deliver that one first and then deliver yours or even a couple of them. So you should have got your meal like 15, like, you know, within 15 to 25 minutes. Now an hour later, at least 45 minutes later, bro, you finally get your order. It doesn't matter because you're paying like $10 for delivery. Like, this is the psychotic reality we live in right now. Absolutely psychotic. And for those of you who are like, well, just cook your own food, look at what's happening at Walmart now. You know, like, some of you have lost your damn minds. You've absolutely lost your damn minds. Like, you're like, I get it. You're like, you're falling into extreme complacency. Like, yeah, just cook your own food. Look, guys, this is surge pricing. And they're deliberately making the labels look like they're natural labels. So people know they're digital labels, so they can fool you. It's all psychology. They're taking advantage of people. They're using tricks to get you to buy things. They're getting like Black Friday is the worst time to buy things now. Like, do not buy anything on Black Friday, because what they're doing is they basically jack up the prices and they sell the worst stuff on Black Friday for the most amount of money. So you get the worst deals on Black Friday. Okay. And Black Friday and Cyber Monday. If you look at the same items, you'll get the same items for less and you'll get them faster, because they know everyone's looking for a good deal. So instead, they turn around and get rid of the stuff that they don't want and charge you even more for it. The level of dishonesty, like, America is such a dishonest place to live. It is so dishonest. You know, I heard some of you guys like trying to excuse this total BS. When I had Soraya on the channel, she mentioned, like, you know, she was in New York City and she said, like, it was like $7 for a stick of deodorant at like CVS or Rite Aid. And some of you are like, well, it's always been $7. Like, what the hell is wrong with you? What the hell is wrong with you? It's when you sit back and you just act like this stuff is normal. This is insane. This is absolutely insane. Like, guys, we're all going to be eating bugs soon. It's like, if this continues, like, you don't, and it's like, guys, you can't. There's only so much you can do. I hear craziness. I hear literal craziness from you guys. Literal insanity. Like, you're like, you know, because I've talked about the prices that are skyrocketing at the supermarket. Oh, what you have to do is you have to go and shop at this place. No, you see, you're not shopping in the right place. You shouldn't be shopping at Walmart. All right, you should. That's for rich people. Shouldn't be shopping at Walmart. All right, you got to go to your like Trader Joe's or something. You guys are like doing like crazy stuff and talking about like this. You got to go for this specific grocer. What kind of stupidity are you talking about where you can't even go to Walmart anymore to shop? Like, when you have to start searching out for like the broken, I don't know. Like, this is, it's insanity. It's insanity. Are there ways to survive? Absolutely. But I'm telling you right now, you know, I have a course that's coming out. It'll teach you how to basically live and survive without even, without even have to shop at these places. But I'm going to tell you, it's not for the average person. When you can't afford, like, you cannot afford to do this anymore, it's ridiculous. There's some idiots who are like, oh, you know, when I said this, like, you know, a lot of a lot of millionaires cannot afford to shop at McDonald's, like buy this garbage anymore. You're like, Angry, you're talking crap. Of course, like, of course they can afford to. That's incorrect. Because a lot of you have like this dumb mentality where it's like, well, if you have $1 million, then you can just go and spend whenever you want to. No. Most millionaires live far below their means. They're not gonna live like you. They're not like us. They're not out there wasting their money and doing the stupidity that we're doing. I'm just being honest. You know, do some eat fast food? Yes, many don't. All right. And you know, to live far below your means, just because you're a millionaire doesn't mean you're spending $1 million. That's how you go broke very, very quickly. You know, it's most of these people are like, they're living off the interest from their money, or they're living off, they get, you know, they, or they collect something from dividends. And even then they're still banking away. They're still saving a lot of that money. You know, their money, that $1 million, that's not money that they're living off. They're not living off that $1 million. They're using that money to, you know, for investments and other things and interest and stuff like that. And then the money that they get from that, they get, you know, they basically live frugally from that. And I'm not saying that they don't live well, but they live below they're living below their means. So they're not going to go out there spending this, you know, dropping $3,000 a month in food, $2,000 a month, 20, you know, this is ridiculous. This is absolutely insane. This is absolutely insane. A lot of these guys, they spend, like, they may have spent $50,000 a year, maybe the amount of money that they may spend over the course of a year. And or they may generate from, you know, their investments and so forth. And they're not spending that on, you know, they don't want to waste all of that money. They want to live as cheap as possible. And it's insane that, you know, you would think that, like, oh, it's okay to spend this crazy amount of money, thousands of dollars a month on food. And you shouldn't have to go trekking to like the cheapest of cheapest places and to go search for these discounts and deals and act like that's ridiculous. This is absolutely ridiculous. And I'm telling y'all, it's only going to get worse. Like, this is madness. Surge pricing, dynamic pricing at Walmart. You know, Target is, you know, you 100% know Target is next. They're just like licking their lips. All right, they've got their flags out and everything, like, hey, like seriously, all right, seriously, because they have a lot of pride when it comes to doing this type of thing, if you get my drift. Guys, if you're enjoying the content on this channel, you want even more of this content, consider checking out the Men Walking Away channel, where I release daily videos. There's a link to the Men Walking Away channel description of video. Go check it out, subscribe to the channel, enjoy the content. And I want to remind you guys also that if you guys enjoyed these videos, make sure to hit the like button. And if you're new to the Angry Guy channel, make sure you subscribe down below. And of course, members for the channel do get videos early. If you'd like to learn more about that, click the join button down below this video. Let me know what you guys think about everything we discussed in the video today. And we'll talk about it in the comments. Like the video if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you like the video, share the video. And just remember that all roads lead to MWA, Men Walking Away, and cheers.